Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel, Base Mechanical Engineering. In this video, I teach you impact of jet on a moving inclined plate. In this video, I explain you this figure of impact of jet on an inclined plate. Then after we derive the force in a different three directions, that is in Fn, Fx and Fy. Then after we derive the equation of work done and equation for efficiency for impact of jet on a moving inclined plate. So first we understand the diagram for a moving inclined plate. So it is a pipe. At the end of the pipe we install the nozzle. From the nozzle the fluid jet is coming with a velocity v, and it is the initial conditions of the plate. This red box is indicating the initial positions of an inclined plate. So when the plate is inclined, we have a certain angle. It is angle is theta. So theta is the inclination angles between the jet and plate, or it is also known as the angle between the jet and the plate. So it is a theta. When the water is strike to this inclined plate, the plate is start to move with the velocity u. Its unit is meter per second. So water is strike to the moving plate with the velocity of v minus u. When we solving the exam case for a fixed plate, at that time the water is strike with the velocity v that is coming out from the nozzles. But for a moving plate, the water is strike with the relative velocity, that is a v minus u. Okay, and after striking, the water is exited from the surface of a plate and it is exhaust as the same velocity as it strike, because we are considering that the surface of the plate is too smooth. That's why water is exit at the same velocity, that is the v minus u. Let we learn the different parameters. V is equal to velocity of jet, that is in meter per seconds. Next is the velocity of the plate, that is u. The plate is moving with certain velocity, it is known as the u, that is meter per seconds. D is the diameter of the jet. This diameter of a jet, that is in meter. Then area cross section of a jet, it is find out from the diameter. It is pi by 4 d square. Its unit is meter square. Next is the m is equal to mass flow rate of the fluid, that is kg per second. And m is equal to rho a in bracket v minus u, because it is the case of the moving plate. For a fixed plate, the mass is equal to rho a v. Okay, in this case we consider the mass is rho a v minus u, because the water is strike with the relative velocity, not an absolute velocity v. So relative velocity is velocity of the jet minus velocity of the blade, so it's called as the relative velocity. When the two parts it's move in a same direction, means jet is striking in this direction, plate is also moving in these directions. Okay, so it is in same direction. At that time relative velocity is minus. When the two part is moving in the opposite direction, means jet is striking in this direction and plate is striking in opposite direction of the jet, at that time the velocity is plus. But in impact of jet case, the both are moving in same direction, that's why relative velocity is minus, that is a v minus u. And last one is the theta, that is the angle between the jet and the plate. Now we find out the three forces. First we find out the force Fn. If you learn something, then like my video and subscribe my channels and share with your friend. So we finding out the force exerted by a jet on the plate in a direction normal to the plate. So first we understand what is the meaning of normal to the plate. Normal to the plate means the force exerted on a plate perpendicular direction to the plate. So plate is inclined at with the certain angles, and we finding out the force perpendicular to the plate means like this arrow directions. Okay, that is a, so how we check it is perpendicular? So this is a plate and this line, so both line have a 90 degree angles with the plate both the sides, then it is known as the perpendicular directions. So we find out the force on a these directions. So equation is Fn is equal to mass upon time into velocity of jet before striking minus velocity of jet after striking. Okay, so velocity of the jet at the striking is v minus u, but it is in the x directions. Okay, and we need to the jet striking in a fn direction, means these directions. So first we need to find out the velocity in n direction. So for that we are try to straight this plate. Okay, so we try to plate straight. At that time what happened, that v minus u is also moving down because we moving this plate vertical. So this angle is theta. So we make the one triangle here, that is hypotenuse is v minus u, that is a theta. Okay, so we have one side, one angle, then we are finding out to able this horizontal direction because we require the velocity perpendicular to this is the plate and perpendicular line is horizontal. So we need to find out this opposite side of this angle, this horizontal line. Okay, so we applying the equation of sine theta. Sine theta is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse. So this side is equal to v minus u sine theta. So here we indicating this velocity on this diagram, that is a v minus u sine theta. So velocity of jet before striking is v minus u sine theta. What is the velocity of jet after striking? It's considered as a zero, not a v minus u, because in a fn direction water is not leaving, it is a leaving with the surface of the plate, so it is in different directions. So velocity of jet after striking is zero. So we putting this value, mass is equal to rho a v minus u, jet before striking, that is a v minus u sin theta, and after striking is zero. So fn is equal to rho a v minus u square into sin theta. So this is the equation of a force normal to the plate. Next we find out the force in x directions and a force in a y direction. So fx is a force in a x directions, that means force in a direction of z or a direction of horizontal directions, or we also talk that it is in a velocity of z directions. For that we draw the here one triangle. So this is fn directions, horizontal direction is fx, vertical direction is fy. So we making one triangle here. Okay, so this is a hypotenuse, that is fn, that is a vertical side fy, and horizontal side is fx, and this angle is 90 minus theta. So on these triangles we are applying the cos 90 minus theta and sin 90 minus theta. So we are finding out this fx and fy. So fx is the adjacent side of this angle. So fx is find out by using the equation of cos 90 minus theta. So first we applying the equation for a cos 90 minus theta. So cos 90 minus theta is equal to adjacent side upon hypotenuse. Adjacent side is fx divided by hypotenuse, that is fn. So we writing these equations and we need to find out fx. So fx is equal to fn into cos 90 minus theta, and cos 90 minus theta is equal to the sine theta, is equal to the sine theta, and we have the value of fn. So we putting in this equation, fx is equal to rho a v minus u square into sin theta. In equation of fn sin theta, again it is multiplied with sin theta. So after that it is a rho a v minus u square into sin square theta. So this is the equation for a fx. Next we find out the fy, that is a component of fn in a perpendicular to the jet, means 90 degree to the x directions. So fy is find out by applying the equation of sin 90 minus theta. So sin 90 minus theta is equal to opposite side upon hypotenuse. So sin 90 minus theta is equal to fy upon fn. We need to find out the fy. So fy is equal to fn sin 90 minus theta, and sin 90 minus theta is also written as the cos theta. So fy is equal to fn sin 90 minus theta, and putting sin 90 minus theta is replaced by the cos theta, and we putting the value of fn, that is a rho a in bracket v minus u bracket over square into sin theta, and multiplied with the this cos theta. So this is the equation of a fy. So this way we finding out the three forces, that is fn, fx and fy. Now we are going to find out the work done and efficiency. Before I request that, I request you to subscribe my channels and share with your friend. Now we finding out the work done. Before that, I writing this equation of fx that we find out. Now work done per second by the jet on a plate. So work done is equal to force into distance in a direction of force. But in this impact of jet, there is a no velocity, is no distance is given. That's why we are considering the velocity instance of this distance. Okay. And this force is considered as a fx, fy or fn. We have a three forces, that is fx, fn and fy. But in this equation of force, we are considering the fx force. Why we are considering fx force? Because this plate is moving in a x direction. So in a equation of work done, we are considering the force is fx. So we putting this value of fx into distance in a direction of force, that is a velocity u is considered. So force is work done is equal to fx into u, fx is equal to these equations into the velocity. So work done is equal to rho a in bracket v minus u square into sine square theta. So this is the equation of fx and it is multiplied with the u. So it is the equation of for a work done. Next we find out the efficiency. So efficiency is equal to output upon input. What is our output in this case? Our output is our work done. So this we have the equation of work done divided by input. What is input? That is a water energy coming out from the nozzles. So it is a kinetic energy. It have a velocity, so it's have a kinetic energy. And kinetic energy is find out by using the 1 by 2 mv square. So it is a work done on plate divided by kinetic energy at input. Instead of this work done, we are putting these equations and divided by mv square by 2. Now in this equation of kinetic energy at the input, we are considering the mass. So we are considering which equation of the mass, that is a rho av minus u or a rho av. So we are considering the rho av for a input kinetic energy at input, because water coming out from a nozzles with the velocity v. So for finding out the mass coming out from the nozzles, we are considering the rho av. Okay, so water coming out with the nozzles with v velocity, but it strike the plate at a v minus u. So this mass m is considered as a rho av. So these equations divided by rho av into v squared. So here it is converted rho av cube, and these two is going on the upper direction. Rho a rho a is cancels. Then after you get the final equations for the efficiency. Thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like my video, subscribe my channels and share with your friend.